I did type title. I'm not adjusting camera. I'm typing title. How are we doing today? Holiday, real quick. My people, good day everybody. So today, real quick, I'll take them in stages so that everything will just align, you know. This rape issue of the little girl by this Baba Ijesha person, my wife tried for an hour to let me try and let me know who Baba Ijesha was yesterday. Finally, she had to give up. She now went to Google to show me his picture. I now still didn't know the person. You know, I don't watch Nollywood films. I even hardly, you know, I'm a serious kind of person. And Nigerians don't really have the kind of film I want to watch. So, I don't really, at least the kind of film I would like to see from African people, you know. So, I don't really watch it. So, I'm really happy that that rape issue happened. This whole African, you know, and me, grandma, don't talk about broke. So, this is my ancestors, where they align everything for me to. Now, what does it mean to be broke? Many people, you know, this broke, among us Africans especially, being broke as a word has taken a life of its own. It don't become now. You understand? But we forget in a past tense of a verb, break. The word broke is the past tense of the verb break. The word broke comes from the word to break, right? Good. So what does it mean to break a man, to break a human being? What does it mean when a human being is broken, is broke? You understand what I'm saying? I'll tell you when we started, when humanity, when all these Oyibo people, when we Africans begin to use this word among ourselves. It comes from the colonial and slavery time. It comes from this colonial and slavery time. When Europeans don't finally conquer our ancestors back in the day, with slave trade, don't they? Nobody can stop it, nobody can resist it. You know, the resistance we would get wasn't strong enough. So now the colonizer and slave master, the imperialist, and the imperialist first job when he carry the noise na my gen, sorry, na my generator, which I won't do. Wait, hold on guys, let me try and lock this window, whether I go reduce the Well, that would be better. I don't know. I think that's a bit better. So, now, the first job of somebody will buy a human being as slave. You know, because whether you call a human being a slave or not, a human being a human being. So, what you must do is that their first job is to break the person, to make you accept your situation. You understand what they tell you? The first job of the oppressors back then, the colonizers and the imperialists, when they grab the man, you know, to the plantation or for Nigeria here to make you work for nothing or to make you bow down, you as a proud person, the first thing they must do is to break the person. You know, if you are into animal training, you know, people that train wild animals like lion, you know, you see all these lions where they act like pets inside people's house. You understand? That lion has been broken. They have to break the lion because they don't feel like I can keep in nature. If that lion keep in nature and you put her inside that house, it will eat you. You see horses no agree make you ride them until you break that horse. You must break him in. You know, it's a psychological term where people been they used back in the day. So our forefathers, You know, those ones when they resist, you know, even though they did the plantation, when they try to escape, those ones for Africa, when they fight against the colonialists still, even as weak as they thought we were, you know, we're culminating to all our freedoms. Those Africans among us, when no Greek submit, now then begin the yab the house niggas, we don't submit, we they enjoy under Oyibo. You don't understand what I tell you? For Africa, you begin to yab those ones where they serve for inside their civil service, where they help them to oppress us. We were now the world, they yab all the military and policemen of those days, the so-called Hausa boys, the Glover boys. You understand? Where they protect Oyibo, now them, the suffering Africans, so-called suffering Africans, so-called uneducated slaves of America, now them they call slave, broke. Say those niggas are broke, those people are broke, those black people are broke because they are acting crazy. They are accepting servitude. You understand? That now the beginning of using the word broke for human beings. See, now we, when they resist, you understand? Now we, when they resist oppression, they call those ones when they assist oppression broke. And at the abyss, they pain them past with that. It's in their pain there. But now, here's the catch 22. These motherfuckers among us, now they hold back. Now they be clerk that time. Now, as from clerk, they don't, they promote them to, now they be Korofo. Now, from there, they promote them to head of state. Imagine, you will be security guard of Oyibo. You are ruling the country. You are ruling the country. So they put all this, they are broke people, because you know, when you are close to the oppressor, they give you dividend of your blood, of your people's blood. They give you some share. And they give their share here. Now they sit there. So they now have the power to control the narrative. They now change the meaning of broke. So now, when we call them broke, that's because they call us broke based on say no bar. You understand? They now reversed it on their, now them be the right for news, now them get all the, now them get all the black newspaper, now them get all the black schools, now them get all the black churches, and then they pay all the pastor money, and then they pay IS tech. You understand? So those people, these actually broken men, you understand? Because you see, all these men when they rule Nigeria today are broke. Because what does it mean to be a broke man? It means that you have no interest whatsoever in bringing your will to the fore, that you have no will of your own. The African intelligentsia, the African elites are broke. They are broken because they have no independent will. They have no vision. They cannot act on their own. They have no independent line of thought or action. But they reverse the idea on us. Say, we are broke because we don't have money. That is money that determines whether you're broke or not. You see the catch 22? You see the way they flip them around? So paying all their artists, all their pastors, all their teachers, all the newspaper editors, because they get everything for the black community, begin to change the world. You understand? So now, we as revolutionaries, we as resistance fighters, we as community organizers, we stand on the side of the people. We no get back. But we still get will. We have our life force still in our hand. Listen to me, my brothers and sisters. The moment another man decides, the moment the final decision of the things you do in your life lay in the hand of another man, and you admit and submit yourself to that situation for any reason whatsoever, no matter the incentive, no matter the pain, the torture, that is the moment you become broken. That is the moment you become broke. Do you understand? So when all these people, they behave anyhow for Nigeria, when would see our leaders, we don't do anything because they are broken. It is simple. And it shows for their behavior, they don't act well. And I don't forget, say, Oba Sanjo go rape, not be rape. This one not be rape. They say that consensual, the son also in a rape. But the son say, Oba Sanjo sleep with his wife. Only a broke man will do that. How can you sleep with your son's wife if you're not broken? You have been broken. You are so damaged that you have no control. You think that lack of control is power. But that's not power. You just don't have control. You don't have control. I'll come into all those levels. I will link them with this whole brokenness to rape. Now I will link everything join. To this, our Africans in Nigeria, why they tell you now? Because everything is one. It's connected. If you understand what is truly going on in this fucked up country, or rather this geographical expression as a Awolowo Kola, if the founding fathers of our country can call it a geographical expression, made geographical expression, then. So now, we as young people, so that you are not broke, this worst term in the African community, say, we don't make them the worst term. Being broke is basically the worst terminology for anybody in this world. So they make us look up to them. So the more we look up to them, the more we become broken. You understand? The more we look up to broken people, the more we become broken. But they make us feel like, say, money for pocket now make you whole, healthy. No, fam. No, fam. You are broke. So we all look up to these degenerates. That's the word I use for the African elites. Forget that, even by the way they consume, they are degenerates. It's like, no control, just depraved. Like, they do everything so in a disgusting fashion, like the way they consume, just everything. So now, we live in a country, and one of the main characteristics of broken people is their inability to really defend what is necessary. Because, they don't have real priorities. Their priority is themselves, their survival. See, because they don't mistake, the broken person has put surviving above thriving at worst. At best, the person, they equate the two, they equate surviving and thriving. Say that the same thing, surviving and thriving are the same thing. But majority of them, they just want to survive. You understand? So, when you just want to survive, you cannot think about anything outside yourself. Even your children are not as important as you. You are number one of everything. So you can never see them protecting that which is necessary outside of self. So when we live in this kind of country, you can see these broken people protect themselves with everything, but they will have nothing to share to the people. They have no idea. They cannot project nothing positive. They cannot protect what is not them. No matter the resources you give these people, they cannot protect what is not them. They can protect their own self. They can protect their self to the extent of, you don't see our people, they move. These people, they move inside convoy before. The convoy, who won't touch? One governor say they're shooting convoy. Pooh, crap. They're shooting convoy. Okay. Did they touch him? You can't touch them. You can't go to their house. is the best house. They have house in all the best place in the world, but they don't think that common man need just small pan roof over your head, they just construct one room for anywhere for a man just day. But for themselves, their children, you know, they'll go them to the best school, but because their children is a reflection. Not because they like their children, you know. Let me tell you people something. It is not because they love their children. It's because their children is a reflection of them. They know that if you see their children suffering, you think they are suffering. You understand what I'm saying? Nothing comes from love. The children are just a reflection of them to them. Don't let people think that that's all. If those children try to interfere with in survivor, he would pick himself above that child. Gara. I never hear any politician speaking before come and say, I want to be like my father. Until he grow, raise head, don't come, wait, don't become full oppressor. We want you to more. When they're young, you can never see them. They can never, if you be a friend like this, I know they hate, all of them hate their parents, die. But as they grow, when they say, me go, I be mugu, I don't get anything, no sense, so I need to tap into more. And then too, they've already been broken from a young age. Broken from, you know, you where you stay with those kind of people from inside, they'll break you from a young age. Where in many different ways. So now these motherfuckers are tasked with defending our country. Yesterday, Buhari said he don't ask American government to bring the headquarters of AFRICOM from Germany come to Africa. Shey una know how much these people don't collect from us Nigerian people in the name of defense budget, in the name of security budget. All governors in this country collecting security vote unaccounted for, unknown figure. Government governors in Nigeria collect an unknown figure of amount every month from us the people in the name of security vote. For inside our budget, defense takes more than education, more than housing, more than healthcare. But they cannot defend this country from bandits, not be from organized army. They're not talk say Ghana invade us, our army no fit fight. This is the same Nigerian army we go destroy everybody for Liberia, a whole country. Go for Sierra Leone, destroy everybody for Sierra Leone. Then they beg us, say, I'm on a come out, we don't agree, we don't fight again. The two countries where we go do peacekeeping, the country say if their only requirement for peace is that Nigerian army should just first go first. As soon as Nigerian army leave, they will settle. Now this is Nigerian army. We don't collect trillions in the last 10 years. Nobody's in jail. Say, procurement of arms. So we don't get arms to fight bandits. How many people they don't prosecute or even put their name out? Who is in charge? Who is saying anything? All these billions, trillions of naira, billions of dollars, when Nigeria don't sink into this motherfucking military and police and army and air force people all over this country, whether they slap us for street, I see that they're strong pass, go for toll gate, they open shot on innocent Nigerians, because they tell us now, say, to fight bandits, they need America to come and open base in Nigeria. Wow. So yesterday, yesterday, the gay news come out. So me, I understand all the news for Nigeria. Run, yeah, carry the gay story. Everybody jump on top. Hey. But they don't really mention this national rape. What won't happen to us, brothers and sisters? I beg, more go Google. Just Google American base Okinawa rape.
nowhere where American army land where they don't rape war. See, that they watch films say America are good country, what would they tell you now? Tell you now. Make the base come. When I go and learn within the American army. See, that they be good guys. The good guys. When I go learn. Maybe after now come understand within people like me don't talk about this country. What they call United States for a long time. This government, they talk say, so they need to look this game on because they don't agree and finish. We need to get ourselves to one senator, yes, senator, he don't stand up for senators. So say, this is not the time to show pride. This is not the time to show that we are independent. We need help in this country. The security apparatus of Nigeria has collapsed. The security apparatus of Nigeria has collapsed. The same day, that evening, Buhari is talking to America to bring American peace here. So me, God, I politically, I miscalculate. Because I did say, all these their violence, when they pay their thugs to put all over Nigeria, now because they won't manipulate election with violence. I can't see, say, no be that one. They won't bring their guys come stay for our backyard new. By the time we're all afraid. Yeah, yeah, let America come and save us. America will not come and put their base in Nigeria. What do you think it will take to get that base out of there? Eh? What do you think? What do you think? So, we did the level now, we say we cannot even defend ourselves from bandits in Nigeria. But billions and trillions don't enter inside our military budget. Honorary NSA national advisor of the Federation, what's his name? Dasuki. Is he the J now? 2.5 billion and they give only where they say he mismanaged. That's one little thing. They see $43 million inside one apartment for Ikoyi. Now don't forget, when I know who say they get that money, Nigeria Intelligence Service. Now you see they get that $43 million cash. They just put that cash inside apartments. And then one come claim out, say that they are own. Before the whole thing cut, they expose them. Say that looted money. So, you know, imagine the kind of money where this our country they pump into defense and this partner they want to bring a military base into this country. Because of bandits. Right? That's the, so now the game with the, because no understand, say AFRICOM don't they pay Nigerian politicians long time. Now when Africans start to pay money to countries for Africa, starting with Algeria, we get a military terrorist problem. Now in Nigeria say begin get terrorist problem. They begin give us military aid. Anybody they hear about the money Nigeria they collect in military aid for Africa, for America every year, that will never do them. Now that the bam of a whole base they won't collect on top of our head. And these men, the funny thing that these men are all about to die. These men are all about to die and leave this country and leave us in this mess where they create. When you understand the gravity of waiting the ground. So you see this broke man, now let me bring it down to society. This broke man where they rule us, they are broke men, all of them are broke beyond repair. Because see, this will not be money cannot solve this nonsense. And they tell you that so not be money doesn't make a man whole, money doesn't make a man say money doesn't make, you can be a billionaire and be broken. Because you cannot, because once they don't take away your capacity to be, once you give up your capacity, because that is everything that the oppressor wants from you. Your oppressor wants you to believe that you're not here to make history. I keep telling everybody, because people keep deferring themselves to me. Oh, give me 1 second, everybody. People keep deferring themselves to me, deferring themselves. Looking for the special Nigerians. See, before Nigeria can truly break free from this problem, what we did, we as Nigerians must kill the special Nigerian. There is no special Nigerian. Everybody, the moment you are born, the ancestors give you the consciousness to make history. Everybody is here to make history. This is what all these social media feeds on, what do they call say, well, they self-involved, you know, they are feeding your ego and all those kind of things, because they don't take our ability to make history. Come bastardize them. It can't mutate, turn to ego inside us. So instead of us to be trying to make history, we are trying to protect our fragile egos that has been got broken. We are broken, fragile. Everybody's so fragile, fam. The number one issue where these oppressors want from you is to take your historical history-making ability away from you. So you see yourself as somebody that should be acted upon, not somebody that should act. We all want to be part of somebody's act instead of being actors ourselves. If I form MOP the way that they expect, because that's not the way I'm going to form it, that's why I'm bringing in as more people as possible. MOP cannot be Sheung Kuti's act, because then if you follow that, you just have illusion of action. Now only me be actor. We, you must be, it must be your act as well. We must act together. You understand? So, your first job is to remove this, your history making ability. You think that you are not here to change it, you are waiting, looking. Now, this, man, sometimes I just feel like we take half a step forward, then we do triple jump back. Triple jump, half step forward, triple jump back. When I do show with one of my friends, her name is Emma. I don't invite her to come my life before. One of the few people who don't come my life, you know. And Emma, a very, you know, Afrocentric feminist. That's the word I'm going to use for, because she's still a feminist, even though she won't deny her sometimes. She's an Afrocentric feminist to an extent. So she had me on her show. She has a great show called Tribe XX. Yes, Tribe XX. And we talk about rape for the show. So I can't tell her, say, and many of her followers disagree with me. They say, me, I dodge the question. I don't want to embrace the question. But the team say, they don't understand the situation. They still say the question, not just question. But the rape question in Nigeria is a situation. Tribe with XX2X. The rape thing in Nigeria is a situation. What Nigeria needs to understand is that as a country, our political, business, religious, educational elite, they have embraced rape culture. They don't embrace rape culture. And that is the real problem. As long as that culture, they prevalent for society, as long as these broken men control society, you understand, they protect the culture that enables them to rape the whole nation. The culture of Nigeria, the only culture I see in Nigeria, is rape culture. And rape culture is reinforced every day. But these same people that reinforce rape culture want to act like they don't like rape. How can you have rape culture without rape? When are we going to start removing rape culture from our minds, from our behavior, from our relations with ourselves? Listen, I'm calling out the entertainment industry here. If the female actresses of this country truly want us to track addressing rape in this country, let's form a database anonymously, all of you. List all the men that have raped or attempted to rape you in the industry. Let's purge ourselves of rape first in our industry. The rape culture that is prevalent. Let me tell you, in the entertainment industry, that's what killed me too. That's what killed me too. Majority of people in the entertainment industry have experienced rape. Majority of our women have experienced rape in this industry. But because the people that did it are those that are on top of the industry that keep the bread rolling, people keep fuck quiet about it. I don't say nothing. Let's form a database in this country and list everybody in our industry that has raped one of you actresses while you were coming up. Can we do that? Can we truly help the people? Can we truly help the people of this country? Can we come out and really name these motherfuckers? Can any actress in Nigeria say that she just experienced rape, successful or not? No actress in Nigeria can say that she has not experienced rape in this our industry. Should we go to the music side? What our women go through in this country? In the churches? Can women in the churches come out and speak the truth and not be attacked? Listen, governments, in government office, female minister, did you hear the minister, that woman, former MD of NDDC, that said she slapped Akpabio because Akpabio was trying to force himself on her? She was the MD of a government parastatal. They wanted to still rape her. Who you be? If 10 women come out and accuse you of rape, I don't need evidence. In fact, if 3 women come outside, 10, what am I saying, 10? If one woman come out and accuse you, no evidence, no text, no anything, okay, it's a lie, they look. As soon as the second one come out, I believe. Yes, I believe, fam. It's now left to you to prove your innocence to me. As soon as number 2 come out, I believe. What industry in Nigeria? Where don't we? So in this country, rape culture. Let me first of all tell you something. We human beings, we think we are special too much. Have you seen what has happened to our Babbage? Not our Babbage. Don't you know that is rape? What Tinubu and Shagori and Lagos State Government did to the Babbage of Lagos is rape. They rape nature. Everybody keep quiet. Look at what they are doing to our forests. Look at what they are doing to our rivers. Look at our environment. Look at the sanitation level of our environment. They are raping it in our presence like this. What is looting of our nation? What is looting of our nation if it's not the rape of all of us? The destruction of the educational system, the healthcare system in this country, this is rape. That is rape culture. We keep quiet. And you think they will look at one woman as something special? When we all keep quiet in the face of rape culture, we accept it, we embrace it. We embrace it in the church, we embrace it in the mosque, embrace it in schools. Embrace it everywhere we see it. Then we will bring out one story one time so that everybody can act righteous. We sit down with rapists, we hail them. rapist up and down, no repercussion, nothing is happening. I had a manager one time that told me, oh, when the band had that, he had his case about rape. Oh, Sean, you are friends with the band. How can you still be friends with him? You have to distance yourself. She said, if I don't distance myself from him, she's going to quit. I said, I can't because of one person's allegation. You know, there's no evidence that I've seen that has convinced me. It's his word against hers, you know, and he's handling it. He's put himself out. You know, police is investigating. Whatever they come up with, it is what it is. You understand what I'm saying? But she thought that meant that I was excusing rape. She quit her job. I don't know how the case ended at the end of the day. But now, we live in a country where governor married small pikin. People defended this act. I'm not saying Muslims should not do what they want to do as culture, but once you are in public office position, there are some kind of things that we must not encourage. Tradition is not enough as an excuse. So when she quit, she made me start reflecting, like, oh, am I helping? Am I covering up for my friend's rape? But at the same time, I looked at, I know him well, I mean. If people will come up and talk, it won't be one person. If he does that kind of thing, he won't have done it to one person. And I say like this, if another person says it, I can delete his number until I really know what's going on. So all these things we see in our community, in our society, friends will be telling themselves that they are raping girls, they'll be excusing it. Some women will go as far and tell you that, my husband, the first time we had sex, he raped me. It's a sign of love. They will repeat that, nobody can counter it, nobody says anything. Rape culture in this country is so embedded in everything that we do, is in the music, is in the film. I say you even watch film, that they will be excusing rape inside the film. So you see, we live in a country controlled by broken men who cannot defend their country from outsiders. Just the way broken men cannot defend their women from rapists. This is what I don't like that men do. Oh, talk about men rape case, talk about men rape case. Men have the power in this world to talk about their own rape case. Men being raped is bad, but we are more in a position of power in society. If more men are willing to come forward about rape, male rape will stop. The problem we are having here is that women who cannot defend themselves, nature that cannot defend itself. So what are we really doing to end rape culture in our communities, in our nation, in our country? We must change our value system. You see, religion tells man that a man, this world is created for man. Woman is created for man. Then they now twist it with capitalism to say that man has rights to take anything he wants in this world. Don't you understand how that is destructive? How can you embrace women? I'm talking to you now, women. How can you embrace a religion that places male needs above your existence? So what are we that we say that we are what it means not to be broke is to stand up to these things. Is to stand up to these things. Look at our religion that people follow, go to church and mosque. And you follow capitalists, or these people believe that they can take anything. That the world is their own to take. They want to take. There's no way. People that marry will tell you that I cannot rape my wife. What's the meaning of that? What do you mean? Which God gives you the right over the woman? The woman's wishes. Women, you have to stand up to all these doctrines. Women have to stand up to all these doctrines. You have to begin to resist. And trust me, you have allies on the other side. We need to go the long mile with you on this issue here in our, to make sure that society never normalizes what women go through. You see, you have to understand why this religious mentality, capitalism, must always breed this rapist. You see, nature and women, woman and nature is the same. Nature is what gives birth to life. Nature is life. You understand me? And among us human beings, who can give birth to life? Only woman. You understand? So all these anti-natural ideologies, you understand, that create concrete jungles, that think that man should be above nature. You understand? You know, man should be one with nature. They believe man must be above nature. So you see, this kind of thinking is what creates these people that also, as they defile nature, they want to defile women. They feel that women are theirs to take because might is right. You see, please, if for anything at all, I'm going to beg women in this world, if for some reason women in this world are able, through this feminism that people are doing, or you know, if it truly lands us in a situation where women come to positions of power, you have to at least imagine a new world. You have to imagine a new world. Women cannot take power just because they want to become the new men. No. No, 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 no. No, no, you can't do that. Please. You see, because today in the world, we have many women running big corporations. I say it, through feminism, the movement for women's liberation, women are running arms manufacturing companies that are creating bombs to kill other women and children. So women must be coming into these positions not to continue arms proliferation, but to reverse it. So that's why I'm begging women, no? Because these people must, this system that we live in is a system that is created to defile nature. And since woman is the most natural of humans, since only a woman being is complete human, because only women can experience the entirety of humanity. You understand? So the people that tell you a lie that this world is a man's world, that is man that is Oga, that is man that God first created, that is man God did this for, is man God did that for, these people that must tell you this lie are jealous of the fact that only women are full human beings. Only women can get pregnant and give birth to babies. Men cannot experience this. Men cannot experience this. So we cannot experience the totality of humanity. Only women can experience this. So this battle is highly spiritual. This battle is truly against what is God, that we call what is good. I'm always happy when rape issues take form in our society, because we can link it directly to our own general rape from these same people. You understand what I'm saying? the same kind of stupid excuses our politicians give for looting and raping our country is the same stupid excuses that rape apologists give for excusing rape. They will vote you after you promise the people to repair the country. They will put you there, finish, you go begin thief. You go say, hey, why are the people not fighting for their rights? At the same time, after you go see rapists, you go say, why did the woman wear short skirts? You understand? You understand what I'm saying to you? These things are all connected. And we as a nation, we must begin to reject all these people. Anybody that is willing to rape his nation will rape a woman. So let's first of all minus anybody in our life that we know is involved in raping this nation. Let's stop excusing that rape. Because as we're excusing that rape, you are giving that rapist the power to now personify his behavior. When someone is a criminal exploiting the hard work of other people, you understand? In a way, he's raping the effort of those people. It's only a matter of time before that person personifies his behavior. You understand? It's only a small time before you know the person don't personify that behavior. The person is not fully doing it to human beings as he's doing it abstractly. How many rape do you think happens in the Catholic Church to little boys? In the Anglican Church, Methodist Church to choir girls? Do you know how many girls in Nigeria there are? Listen, any girl that has no experience rape in Nigeria today is one of the luckiest people alive. If you are a girl and you have not experienced rape that somebody forced themselves on you or tried to, you are a unicorn. You are as rare as a six-eyed frog. You are as rare as a four-tailed snake. So we must face rape culture, and our celebrities in this country, we have the power. You have allies on the other side. We must now come outside and start purging society. Let Nigeria go through its own Me Too, I beg. Let Nigeria go through its own Me Too. Let Nigeria go through its own Me Too. Let's expose all these powerful people that have abused their power in your presence. Yeah. Let's go deep into this issue. It's truly a sorry state in this country where people go through all these kind of things. You know, and then the successful ones, you know, this is what really kills me. That it is the biggest rapist in the industry. That's why you see now in America, you know, see the kind of Harvey Weinstein, man. The biggest rapist can make the biggest stars. And now the biggest stars don't even want to talk about their rape anymore. Because it's so behind them. They don't want to relieve the trauma. They believe that their success equates as balanced it. No, I don't want to go back there. But it is the strength of those people that can validate the stories of the little ones. So it's not only the young actresses that have been molested left, right, and center that must speak. Those women at the top. I say, I'm telling you that when that woman was talking that Fabio tried to rape her, she was saying it on Arise TV, on Chinese TV too. The minister tried to rape. People thought, they didn't like saying, she not talk anything. This was not, the people were talking about, off your mic, and all those kind of things. Some a woman, MD of NDDC, MD of a government. Where does a woman have to rise to in life that these men do not see her as property or something they can just co-opt? Where do you think they're not escaping? If this woman, because I'm sure she must be married, she must have children. Maybe she even has grandchildren. But this man still wanted to force himself on her. Not be say them say. You think it's only Nigerian that go to England, Prime Minister Boris Johnson. They caught him beating his wife to stupor in his house. Is it all Trump case, all Trump story? Degenerates. Degenerates. That's the word. See, if an old guy marry a young girl, if an old guy marry one young girl, put for house, okay, maybe it's love. Maybe it's love, okay, fine. But this man, they are chasing all the girls all over town all the time. Don't you understand that these are degenerates? This is not healthy behavior. Because it is steeped in deceit. During the day, you are a family man with children and wife in your house. Jesus Christ and Muhammad close to you. Thumping up your nose at immoral attitude and behavior. But these same men are chasing all the small girls all over town. Everybody is just... Not until they get one. They don't get one. They don't get two. They don't get three. They don't get four. Not be here with them for Nigeria where they say two small girls come from Canada, come they film Otedola, say they fuck them for Nigeria. Say one black man Otedola with sex tape. How two small girls, they get the second richest man in Nairobi, the one of the richest men. How did those small girls? We grown-up men cannot even get appointment with him. We grown-up men cannot even see this guy to help our life, to invest in our... You have to die to get appointments with these kind of people. Yet, two young girls from Canada have your video of you having sex. You have to be using police to oppress them, to arrest them, to deport them, to use all your power. Those also not go to Canada, they see you to court. You two now, maybe you can go to Canada, maybe you can go. I don't know, I mean, what's going on? That go take say, no, that go take say, get to you, no. Ah. Universal Limited, no, you know that hotel is recent. When they put Baba Yash for this one was 3 years ago, two like Indian girls from Canada. You see, Nigerians, you always forget everything. You forget. Any small thing. You don't forget. You know, any small thing, I don't forget. I'm not players. It was in the news everywhere. It was there in the news by itself. Let me be talker. It was in the news by itself, see. So what did they talk? So these are the people, they are broken, broke. That's why you can live in a country like that. Now look at this country. I mean, look at Nigeria. Look at the country they live in, look at the country they are in charge of. You have to imagine giving this country with all the resources. Your country has to be like your house. Imagine if Nigeria is a house. If Nigeria is somebody's house, just imagine if Nigeria is a house. Say that one not be Chris Person house. Is a man, you go say, does mean go there inside the parlor, the bed sheet for the room go down tear. I mean, then the owner of the house won't get one fine room where he just do for himself, where he pays, where he let anybody throw the thing inside. But the whole house, not full, not dirty, no paint, no anything, not scatter. That's how they can live in a country like this. Because when you are broke, you have no pride. You no longer have pride because pride comes from being able to accomplish real stuff, accomplish real things, man. So nobody should tell me that they want to go and bring Africans before they can defend us in this country. We have given you people billions of dollars to defend us. Billions. So it's either you tell us that the people you've given those billions to are incompetent, and then you begin immediately to prosecute them as is. How can you tell us you want to bring Africom to come and... What is this? Second colonialism? Again? The question that we call there and come, that's because this is what they said about our ancestors. We have to see history is repeat history. You see, we don't sleep. This is what Chiwenzu said in his book. This is what Chiwenzu repeated, predicted in his book, that it will come to a day when they will come back and recolonize us and use us as slaves as they like, and won't be able to defend ourselves, won't be able to say anything about it. And we are there now. We're already there in my lifetime. We're already there in my lifetime. That these people are about to renegotiate the way they are. Because I'm telling these people, they are the same 400 years ago when African kings began to mount up resistance against Europeans, banning the trade of slaves, of goods, banning the slave of trades, telling these people, we no one do anything to Nigeria again. It is this merchant, this capitalist among us that wanted to make money by all means, went behind the back of their kings to continue working with the white, destroying their society, destroying their community, but accumulating wealth for themselves to the extent that they could now topple the traditional hierarchies, the traditional lineages, and impose themselves. These Africans that respect things over people, they have come to the level again to renegotiate our slavery and colonization the way their ancestors did 400 years ago again. Eh? So it's time. It is time. We must resist, though. We must resist more fiercely than any generation of Africans before, or else we'll be the ones in the, or at least maybe we are lucky, not sheep. It's not under sheep they will put you. At least it's plain. They used to be carrying us, you know. So have a good day. I don't talk my own.